few good sports games.
What are the only basketball games I actually enjoyed?
I kind of like the original Double Dribble.
Mm. Well, I also ended up playing the NBA Jams for a game tournament, so.
That's true. Why don't you tell the chat about that?
Okay, a long time ago when there's this thing called Blockbuster. Yeah, I know, hard to believe video store. they held this video game championship in store for Super Nintendo and Sega Genesis. I wanted a bit of a challenge because, you know, my brother owned a Super Nintendo and I played it fairly regularly. And like, I wanted to play Genesis because I never really got to. And so I played Judge Dredd and NBA Jam's Tournament Edition. I ended up as a store champion for the Genesis and won free video game rentals for a year.
Nice.
Yep. I still have my certificate. It's not in the best shape, but I still have it.
That's so cool.
What's funny is the what was on the Super Nintendo at the time, I was really good at because I had rented it before and played it.
Ah.
It was a Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles fighter.
Ah.
And for some reason thought I was on Super Nintendo, so I had me play it. I was doing, you know, my time was up. The dude was like, you know, that was a really good score. You're like the highest score. It's like, yeah, but I played, I was signed up for Genesis. Oh, he still got the good, best score. Because I had actually played it, I knew how to perform the moves of certain characters and stuff.
Let's see. I don't remember much about that game other than I don't remember much about that game at all other than I did play it.
Yeah. That's about all I remember, too. I remember playing it with my brother.
I'm going to assume it's probably not very good.
Actually, it was pretty decent, but, you know, it, like I said, pretty... Nothing fancy enough to really remember.
Yeah.
Yeah, I remember Looney Tunes Basketball, Drax. I liked that, too. But just as a general sports game of NBA Jams, it's like, it's not usually my sort of thing. I don't usually play sports games.
I played some sports games, but it was mostly because those were the only games I could get my dad to play with me when I was a kid.
All those sports games I played as a kid was picking out what football team I thought would win with my dad.
Let's see. Though, I like old school, like more arcadey style or just old school console.
Tecmo Bowl.
Yeah, like Tecmo Bowl or. But I mean, just in general, I like old school like sports games better than modern sports games because I didn't feel like I need to know about sports because they had everything so simplified and fun. It's just like now it's like you gotta know all these stats and all these plays and it's just like what.
Yeah.
It's like Tecmo Bowl. There's only four plays I have to choose from. And all I have to do is run forward and dodge people. I like that. Why can't they just stay like that?
Yeah, you know how it is. We gotta make things, you know, more modern.
Gotta make everything a simulation, practically.
Mm-hmm.
Granted, right now, that's probably the only way some people can get their sports fix.
Yep.
I think I mentioned this, like, when I was playing arcade games
Crunchy.
Crunchy, but yeah, I feel sorry for the people that are really into sports right now because it probably really sucks for them right now.
Mm-hmm.
Because they can't watch any sports, they're all canceled.
I mean, on one hand, I feel bad for him, but on the other hand, you know, I kind of like it.
I mean, it'd be like if video games were canceled, or cartoons were all canceled, I'd be pretty upset. So, you know.
I get it. It's just, you know, one of those things. It's like, being never really into sports in the first place, it's like, you know, hey, this is kind of nice.
It's not something I'm into, but I mean, I'm not gonna hate others for liking them. Or
no, I don't hate on anybody for liking it.
Yeah. And besides, everybody's gotta like something, so.
Well, I always try to, you know, keep an open mind, like, you know, okay, you know, I'm not interested in that, but, you know, I like what I can, the stuff, you know, I like, I consider a lot weirder, so it's like, I can't argue. I can't say anything about it.
Jeebus.
Yeah, I heard about that, Keo. Virtual NASCAR ended up being more interesting than the regular NASCAR.
I heard they were doing simulations of it with the actual, like, NASCAR drivers or something, which is kind of cool.
Yeah.
Like, they having the actual NASCAR drivers drive the simulation or something, and I was like, that's actually really awesome.
I'm sure the athletes are happy their odds of getting concussions severely dropped.
Maybe, but they're probably also getting some severe, like, cabin fever from all this, I'd imagine. Like, not being able to go out and do what you enjoy doing most probably sucks.
And even being cooped up inside and not being allowed to do what you enjoy doing sucks. I know that feeling too well.
Yeah, I'm sure you do.
Well, I was in a religious home for a year of high school, and they didn't like a lot of the things I liked. My favorite experience there was the time they found D&D novels in my bag. They're like, you can't have these, you know. You need to get rid of these. It's like, well, at least you can't take them away from them because I technically don't own them. They plugged to the school.
There you go. Your school had D&D manuals? Nice.
No, novels.
Oh, well, those weren't at my school for as far as I knew.
Well, you were also a little older than me, so.
That probably does affect things.
Not by a lot, but still.
I don't know how I took that much health off of Dracula, but I'm not going to argue with it.
You hit him in the nuts. You see, you know, his balls are in his face.
Oh. Va, do you think this is a chin? It's actually me nuts.
It's not.
No. I'm nutting everywhere. These aren't fireballs. These are sperm suds.
These are sperm balls.
I'm trying to impregnate you, Mr. Belmont.
That's how the vampire disease is transmitted these days.
Biting, that's all fictional.
I just spray you with semen and hope you transform.
It was all subtext. It was all metaphors.
For pixelated bukkake. Excuse me, sir. Sir, can I interest you in some holy water? Made by the Pope himself.
Oh! Old man water.
Well, I mean, there's always, you know, piss water if you prefer that.
What the fudge, Dracula, you cheap ass motherfucker. 69, dude! Okay. No, actually 68. God damn it. I had an easier time beating you in Smash Brothers. What? You didn't like it when I was in Smash? I'm Dracula. I smash them all. Okay. I don't know where I'm going with this at this rate.
I don't think anybody knows.
I'm just saying whatever comes into my head because I'm trying to keep talking while playing. I don't. Stop sperming me in the head, you masturbator.
Damn you, master debater. They'll never take me alive. Quite literally.
Whoa. Ah! Oh, I was right behind you. Time for the jump scare. I'm a FNAF character. You got to battle kid this?
Oh God.
I know what Battle Kid is, but I don't know what you mean by saying that.
Me either.
I mean, my best guess is you're referencing the Game Grumps episode where Aaron played it, but I mean, I still don't get what you mean by saying I need to battle kid this.
Drax, I am very tired at the moment. I can't think straight. I get it now, but, you know, I didn't at first. Essentially, he's talking about the part where, you know, Aaron starts getting better when he's just sitting there talking to Dan.
Oh, okay. I get it now. It's been a long time since I've seen that.
Yeah, same.
Can't remember every single thing the Grumps do.
I'm surprised I even remembered that much. I haven't watched that in ages. Yeah, well, go find somebody that has, you know, an eye roll emote, you know, and subscribe to them, Drax.
All right.
Right now, Crunchy holds my sub. Yeah, if we manage to do it that way, we might have to. And Dark's like, we should say, hopefully you save state before round two. It's like, what trouble was we having with round one? I would hope we do.
Oh, shit.
And they're not.
I don't think there's going to be time for me to save state for round two, though, is the problem. It kind of happens right off the bat. Oh, come on. See, that's the problem. I one hit. Oh, come on, come on, come on, come on. It's like I have to like kill him without taking a single hit.
Mm-hmm. Oh no, he jumped on me.
Then he does the jump, big jump. Fuck.
Do it, Pim.
I'm trying. It'd be nice if I could have take more than one hit of damage, though.
Uh-huh. Give me some food, Dracula. Just give me a, you know, nice leg of chicken.
A nice little turkey leg would be nice.
Maybe some mashed potatoes and gravy. Or maybe just a small container of KFC gravy.
Honestly, wondering if I should try fighting first form again, because so I can at least take more than one hit of damage.
Show you what to talk about here.
I fucking hate this goddamn blue ass cookie monster motherfucker.
You
fucking
suck.
Cookie monster ass bitch. I will
stole my Girl Scout cookies, you bitch.
I will destroy you. C is for cookie, and that's good enough for me.
Me. real reason you're trying to kill Dracula, he stole your Girl Scout cookies.
Well, yeah. These things aren't cheap, man.
No, but the store, but you know, like Walmart and stuff has a cheap brand of them.
It's not the same.
The Thin Mints are.
I don't like the Thin Mints, though. I'm all about the peanut butter patties, dude.
I like those too, but you know.
Or tagalongs, whichever name you want to call them by.
I think they have those.
Okay, how? There was no way! There was no way!
Yeah, it's not like the game gives you a power slide. The game gave us a power slide.
That was bullshit. There was no way I could survive that because without being hit. Motherfucker. Piece of fucking Cookie Monster ass motherfucker.
Yeah, I just don't know if he wants to redo that fight, Drax. As it is, I'm having a hard time, you know, staying awake for this fight.
Come on, piece of... Think all these people say all you have to do on the final boss is just throw the holy water at him and he dies. Yeah, it really is that easy, let me tell you. Thank you. did not press forward. Why did that happen? Wait. I did it! Oh my god! I did it! I beat Castlevania! I beat it! I finally did it! After so many years! After literally so many years! I have beat Castlevania 1. I have been trying to beat this game since I was like, I don't know, 8, 10 years old, somewhere around there. Finally did it. Trans Fisher? Ron Stoker? James Banana? Christopher B? Bela Lugosi? Boris Carl's office? Love Cheney Jr. Barber Sherry. What? Love. Green Stranger. Cafe Bar Reed. Andre. What the? Joan Candies? Simon Belmondo? Belmondo? I played the greatest role in history. I finally did it, guys. I finally did it. Castlevania. Beat it! After so many years. Finally beat it. And I did it.
Let the Michael Jackson's beat it here.
And I was only able to do it because of all of you watching me, all of your support, and Sage States, but mostly your support. We did it. We beat it. We good. So,
yay.
Yeah. Another one beat from my childhood. This is Ninja Gaiden. Woo. Where do I go from here? I don't know, but I'll see you next time. Bye, everybody.
See you, folks.